the Lone Piper on the battlements of Edinburgh Castle.
Next.
Here, on top of Edinburgh Castle, in conditions of extreme secrecy, men are being trained for the British Army's 1st Kamikaze Regiment, the Queen's Own Kamikaze Highlanders. So successful has been the training of the Kamikaze Regiment that their numbers have dwindled from 30,000 to just over a dozen in 3 weeks. What makes these young Scotsmen so keen to kill themselves?
The money's good.
And the water skiing.
Tension!
All right, Sergeant Major, that is. Now, how many chaps you got left?
Six, sir.
Six.
Five, sir.
Good luck, Johnson.
Jolly good, sir, Sergeant Major. Well, I've come here to tell you we got a job for your five lads.
Four, sir.
Your four lads.
Good luck, Taggart.
Yes, lads.
Now, this mission's going to be dangerous and it's going to be tough, and we're going to need every lad of yours to pull his weight. Now, which four are they?
Are these three?
Yes, sir. Okay, off you go, Smith.
Right.
Sergeant Major.
Sir.
You don't think it might be a good idea to stop the training program for a little bit?
They've got to be trained, sir. It's a dangerous job.
Yes, I've heard that, Sergeant Major.
All right, McPherson, you're next. Off you go.
Right.
You see, what is worrying me, Sergeant?
I'll make it a good one, sir.
Good lad, McPherson.
McPherson, only this mission really is very dangerous. We're going to need both the chaps that you've got left.
Both of you, sir.
Sergeant Major, what's this man's name?
This one, sir. This one's MacDonald, sir.
MacDonald. No. Hang on to MacDonald, Sergeant Major. Hang on, then.
I don't know whether I can, sir. He's in the state of Mitsubishi Kyoko Mitsunawa.
What's that?
It's the fifth state Scotsman can achieve, sir. He's got to finish himself off by lunchtime, or he thinks he's let down the emperor, sir.
Well, can't we get him out of it?
Oh, I don't know how to, sir. See, our kamikaze instructor, Mr. Yashimoto, was so good he never left Tokyo Airport.
Well, there must be someone else who can advise us.
Good morning. Kamikaze, please.
Yes. Would you go through, please?
Thank you.
Right, Sergeant Major, no time to lose.
Beg pardon, sir?
No time to lose.
No what, sir?
No time. No time to lose.
Oh, I see, sir. No time to lose, sir.
Yes, that's right, yes.
Yes, no time to lose, sir.
Right.
Is that funny, sir? I've never come across that phrase before. No time to lose. 42 years I've been in the regular army and I've never heard that phrase.
Well, it's in perfectly common parlance.
It was, sir.
Oh, never mind. Right, no time to lose.
Eventually, yes, sir.
What?
Well, like you said, sir, we'll be able to make time eventually without to lose, sir. No.
Look, I don't think you've quite got the hang of this phrase, Sergeant Major.
Morning. No time to lose. Well then, how are you thinking of using this phrase?
I was thinking of using it like, good morning, dear. What is in no time to lose?
Yes, well, you've not quite got the hang of that, have you? No time to lose, no time to lose, no time to lose, no time to lose. Now, you want to use this phrase in everyday conversation, is that right?
Yes, that's right, yes.
Yes,
good.
My wife and I have never had a great deal to say to each other. In the old days, we used to find things to say, like, pass the sugar, or that's my flannel. But in the last 10 or 15 years, there just hasn't seemed to be anything to say. And anyway, I saw your phrase advertised in the paper, and I thought, that's the kind of thing I'd like to say to her.
Yes, well, what we normally suggest for a beginner such as yourself is that you put your alarm clock back 10 minutes in the morning so you can wake up, look at the clock, and use the phrase immediately. Shall we try it?
Yes.
All right, I'll be the alarm clock. When I go off, look at me and use the phrase, okay?
No! Time to lose.
No, no time to lose.
No time to lose.
No time to lose.
No time to lose.
No, to lose, like to lose in France. No time to lose.
No time to lose.
No time to lose.
No time to lose.
No, no time to lose.
No, no time to lose.
No time to lose. The story of the wild and lawless days of the post-impressionists.
All right, you yellow-bellied sidewinder, go for your guns.
Anyway, no time to lose, Sergeant Major.
Look out, sir! Gold! We'll have to hurry, sir. No, put that down. Put that down, lad. He's reached the sixth plane already, sir.
Right, well, here are the plans, Sergeant Major. Good luck.
To you, sir!
And good luck to you, MacDonald.
Thanks, sir. I'm gone, MacDonald. No time to lose.
Very good, Sergeant Major.
Yes, excellent.
So it was that on a cold November morning, RSM Erdoch and Sapper MacDonald, one of the most highly trained kamikaze experts the Scottish Highlands have ever witnessed, left on a mission which was to... Oh, I can't bother this trifle.
Right, MacDonald. No time to lose.
Mission. Now here's the method. RSM Erdoch will lull the enemy into a false sense of security by giving them large quantities of money, a good home and a steady job. Then when they're upstairs with the wife, Sapper MacDonald will hurl himself at the secret documents, destroying them and himself. Well, that's the plan. The time is now 1942 hours. I want you to get to bed, have a good night's rest and be on parade early in the morning. Thank you for listening and thank you for a lovely supper.